The corpse which still attends meetings. Strange stories in history. Jeremy Bentham was an English philosopher of utilitarianism and a social reformer. From 1769, when Bentham was just 21 years old, he requested in his will that upon his death, he wanted his body to be dissected by a friend, the physician and chemist George Fordyce. He had long hoped that the dissection of his body could further help to educate medical teaching in anatomical lectures. During his lifetime, medical research was developing into the science that we know today. In 1830, 2 years before his death, he developed this paper titled Auto Icon, or Farther Uses of the Dead to the Living, which was part of his will. Bentham died on June 6, 1832, at age 84, at his home in Queen Square Place in Westminster, London, England. His friend and physician, Thomas Southwood Smith, followed Bentham's instructions to dissect his body and turn it into an auto icon for display at University College, London. The head was embalmed and his skeleton covered with a frame and stuffed with linen tow, with his favorite clothes placed over the top, and he was posed in a chair as if engaged in thought. But this wasn't the only request. Bentham wrote that his body, or auto icon, should be wheeled into meetings between friends and disciples, commemorating the founder of the greatest happiness system of morals and legislation. The myth developed here that his auto icon would be wheeled out to every university council meeting, where he would be listed as present but not voting. Bentham had imagined that auto icons could take part in theatrical performances and be made to move using strings and wires like a puppet, and for auto icons to replace statues and monuments to people. Bentham's auto icon was acquired by University College London on Gower Street in 1850, where it still sits to this day in a wooden box in the south cloisters of UCL's main building. Bentham wanted his head to be specifically mummified to resemble how he did when he was alive. Unfortunately, the embalming process did not go entirely to plan. Bentham's head preservation went badly because of the mummification process, which was based on the requested method used by the Maoris of New Zealand. Its suspension over sulfuric acid didn't help either. The result was a rotting and discolored head with glass eyes, which looked so bad that a wax head featuring some of the original hair was made as a replacement. Even though this was a macabre sight, the real mummified head nevertheless was eventually put on display, placed at the feet of the wooden box with the body, after it was found in 1898, suspended in the body's rib cage. It became the target for many student pranks, including, some say, football practice. In 1975, some students from King's College London stole the head and held it in ransom for £100, and then down to £10 to be paid to a charity shelter. It was eventually discovered all the way in a locker in an Aberdeen railway station in Scotland. Now it is locked away securely, refrigerated in the vaults of University College London. Many things probably influenced Jeremy Bentham's decision to be turned into an auto icon. One of these was his utilitarianism philosophy, which said that an action is right to be taken if it tends to promote the happiness of the performer and the people affected by the action. Or maybe his sense of humor, as it is said that he carried the two glass eyes in his pockets for 10 years to show friends what he was going to become. While the idea that he attends every university meeting is a myth, he does attend meetings every now and then during college anniversaries, but to do it every time would damage him beyond repair. Because of his vision that education should be more widely available to those who are not wealthy or part of the church, he is seen as the spiritual founder of University College London, where he is placed.
Subscribe for more history videos. Hey, Simple History fans! If you're looking for a better way to support the channel and help us create more epic content, consider becoming a sponsor on our channel. Sponsoring means that for just $5 a month, you get these amazing perks. You can be the first to see new episodes with early access. You'll be able to watch new episodes before anyone else with this perk. A custom icon that shows alongside your username in the comments section and in live chat. When you sponsor us, you also become an influencer. With sponsor-only comments, you can communicate directly with us and help us pick the topics that we'll do next on Simple History. Our videos will continue to be uploaded as usual, and remember, it's not mandatory to sponsor us. Thank you for letting us feed your hunger for history.